Hey, Brent.
Yeah, I had to let you in first just so I could say thank you.
Oh, man. Truly, the pleasure is mine. I mean, really, it's an honor. I mean, the guy is something special that we all know, and you know even better than me because you've had such a long working relationship with him, you know, day in and day out. And but you know, I'm lucky that I've been able to stay in contact with him over the years because I'm judging festivals and he'd be there with his band, and I'm kind and supportive. I mean, uniquely kind and supportive when I arrived at IU, you know, in a way that I just don't think most people would be, you know, just it's really an honor. And yeah. So I appreciate being brought into this special celebration.
We are very, very touched, and man, the piece looks great. I can't wait to hear it.
It's going to be fun. That's what I wanted. I wanted it to be fun. I wanted it to be swinging. I wanted to have just kind of a fun, joyful, you know, presence.
Hey, welcome everybody. You guys want to come say wave to them real fast? Hey, they are on their way. They're going to get here pretty soon, everybody. I'm going to.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming.
Hi.
Cool. So great. Oh, my gosh. Look at everybody. Look at everybody.
You all look so beautiful. Look, Brayer Teague is here.
Wow. It's so fun to see everybody's faces on the screen.
Elliot.
Oh, my gosh.
So just didn't take Josiah along to get a beard after the wedding, which we had decided.
I know. I kind of told him to shave
it. You guys can be over here.
Hi, Owenses.
Hey, newlywed.
That's us. Emily's here too. This is my wife.
Yay! Oh, how cool. Congratulations,
you guys.
Thank you.
I'm so excited for this whole night. I think it's going to be really special. So thanks to everybody that's here. They're on their way.
Yeah, they're literally like 2 minutes away.
Surprise is going to be.
When we took a band trip to New York to perform our two bands at Carnegie Hall together, that was when I finally convinced Glenn to get an iPhone. He had been without a cell phone forever. And then he did that Find My Friends thing with me so we could track each other's buses on the road trip. And he's forgotten to take it off his phone. So I can still see where he is.
That's so funny.
And Gail, I think I saw Gail here. She was the one who finally got him to get a cell phone. Because until then, whenever someone would say, Glenn, can I call you? And you say, yeah, just call Brayer.
Oh, doorbell.
Okay. Oh, are you filming?
Yeah. Hey guys.
Come on in.
You guys ready to go?
Yeah.
Come on in.
Surprise!
Surprise!
Seat for you.
Take a seat.
And a seat for Terry.
Oh, thanks.
So Glenn, you are probably wondering why we are surprising you, and that I think it's important for you to know that the reason is that we don't think Indiana will beat Michigan again for another 30 years. We thought this would be worthy of a party. So yeah. Actually, there are lots of people here tonight to say hi to you, spanning 9 time zones, I think, from West Coast to Europe. There's a lot of big news today in our country, and we know that the president-elect is going to speak in about an hour. So for anyone who's interested in seeing that, I think we'll get you out in time. So I just wanted to make sure that you knew that. But before we go too much further into Zoom land, I do want to just introduce a few people so you know where you are. Welcome to Downers Grove. This is the Teague House. I'm Breyer, if I haven't had the chance to meet you. My wife, Kristen, is here. Kristen, can you come wave real fast? And Emery, come on over.
Hello. Say hello. Welcome.
Happy to have you with us. Not with us, but joining us from Rochester, New York tonight is my son, Miles. So, Miles.
Hi, everybody.
Thank you for being here. Miles. Thanks for being here. We've got Josiah Williams and his wife, Emily Williams, here with us.
Josiah. Hi.
And we have Allison Williams in the house. But the first person, Glenn, that we want to have a chance to say hello to you is someone you know from your IU days, and it's Brent Wallerab. So Brent, I'm going to invite you to go ahead and unmute yourself. I'm going to put this on speaker so we can see you a little bit better. And good evening, Brent.
Good evening. How's that? Can you hear me all right?
Yeah.
Great. Hey, Glenn, it's Brent. And first of all, congratulations. So we have something we want to share with you. So just a large number of your former students and colleagues and friends just wanted to do something really special for you, just to recognize and honor and celebrate just your amazing accomplishments as a teacher. And so I have received the incredible honor of being asked to compose a piece in your honor for jazz ensemble for big band. And so of course that's something that I just so humbly and graciously accepted. And so I wrote a piece for big band. And now the title of this piece is called Bare Bones. Now why is it called Bare Bones? So Josiah and Breyer both thought that a reference to Bear's Place down in Bloomington at IU would be a good thing because it was, a fairly common hang for you and everybody else. So we wanted to put that. And so we bounced some titles around. And so we decided to call it Bare Bones. Now, why Bare Bones? So it's for big band, but not just big band. It's for big band with full trombone section with an additional trombone trio soloing out front. And just so happens the trombone soloists for this piece will be yourself, Glenn, Tim Kaufman, and Josiah himself. So this is a piece featuring the three of you out front of the band in solo trio capacity along with the full big band. Initial idea was to turn this over to you and have you rehearse this with your band, and then we'll do a big special concert. But of course, we can't do that now, given the circumstances. So what we will be doing is over the winter, we are going to be doing a remote recording with video and audio that we will have documented, and of course, featuring the three soloists. So we are going to be putting you to work. You are going to have to learn some technology, which means you're going to have to get a computer interface and microphone and all kinds of stuff. So we're going to get a really beautiful video and audio, just professional studio quality recording of this new piece that I'm so honored to have written for you. And before I'm going to close real quick here, I just wanted to say, back in 1987, when I arrived at IU for graduate school, I came from a little undergraduate school. I was terrified to be placed in David Baker's jazz ensemble. And then when I got there, I was further terrified of David Baker himself, who could be a pretty intense guy, as much as wonderful as he was. And one of the things I'll never forget is you and Tim both. Man, you took me under your wing. You made me feel comfortable. I think I was one or two new guys in the band. The rest of you had been there for years. You knew each other, had all your inside stuff. And from day one, you just made me feel welcome, a part of the band. And it was just one of the truly great, loving, kind gestures I've ever experienced. So congratulations with a lot of love. Breyer is going to present the score for you.
I do want to show you just on the inside cover because these are the people that are tuning in right now.
Oh, cool.
So
That's the dedication to you, and these are the people who made it happen.
Thank you.
So I want to give one of our soloists a chance to chime in and say hello. Tim Kaufman, if you could unmute and say hi.
Of course. Thanks, Brer. Such a wonderful night. Congratulations, Glenn. Nobody more deserving than you. I'm overwhelmed to be here. And you've had such a great career. We all knew back in college, we made fun of you all the time for all kinds of different reasons, but we knew you'd be such a great teacher. You were such a great person and such a great trombone player, great musician. And it's so hard to believe how the time has passed by. I just can't believe it. You're sitting there with your son who just got married. That's crazy. Yeah. So anyway, I'm honored to be a part of this. I think I was supposed to speak on the tune being in the key of F. So when Brent called me, he was just wanting to talk to me about the chart. And I said, well, of course, you know, medium swing, key of F. If you're a trombone player, key of F means the key of love. So that's the key that we all like to play in.
Beautiful.
So Brent accommodated that. I did see the high F in the part. So I think we're going to have to hand that over to Josiah because I can't play a high F. Anyway, it's an honor to be a part of this. And Glenn, congratulations. So let's raise our glasses here to our dear friend Glenn Williams. Congrats on a great career, and nobody more deserving than you.
Oh, thanks, man.
My dear friend.
We haven't drank on a Zoom meeting in a while, Tim.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been at least 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, Tim, thanks so much for being here. We are going to transition into a few more toasts. So I want to make sure everybody's got something that they can toast with. You want me to hold that for you?
Please.
Our first toast is going to be given by Dr. Peter Kupfer. And he is with us tonight representing Highland Park High School, which is where Glenn began his teaching career in 1988. Dr. Kupfer is currently the associate professor and chair of the Department of Musicology at Southern Methodist University's Meadows School of Music. Peter received his PhD in music history and theory from the University of Chicago in 2010 and is a two-time Fulbright Fellowship recipient for his dissertation research in Russia and for a research project on the reception of Wagner in the German Democratic Republic. As a teacher, Peter has taught at the University of Chicago, DePaul University in Chicago, and Reed College in Portland, Oregon. At SMU, Peter teaches seminars on Beethoven, Shostakovich, music and multimedia, film music, music and politics, and music history pedagogy, as well as research methods and the second half of the undergraduate music history survey. And while all that sounds pretty impressive, really, Dr. Kupfer's most prestigious claim to fame is that I started him on the bassoon in fifth grade at Elm Place Middle School.
Yeah.
Yeah. And somehow I managed not to screw up his ambition for music. And I passed him on to Glenn, where Glenn was his band director at Highland Park High School. So, Dr. Kupfer, the Zoom is yours. Welcome.
Thank you very much. This is quite a blast from the past. Hi, everybody. Hi, Glenn. Hi, Terry. This is... I'm a little overcome as well. Thank you, Brer, for that wonderful, way too long introduction. But it's quite an honor here to speak on behalf of the Highland Park High School era of your illustrious career. Before I do so, I just want to thank Brer for asking me to say a few words and also for organizing this. It just says so much about someone that their friends and their colleagues are willing to go to such lengths for them. So thank you, Brer. And thank you, Glenn, for everything. As I said, I'm very honored to represent the Highland Park High School era of your career. My earliest memories of you go back to the late 80s when I wasn't yet in high school, but my sisters were. And I tagged along as the pesky younger brother on a bunch of band trips. And at the time I played violin, if you may remember, but it was on those trips and just seeing what, you know, how everyone loved you and loved being in band that I decided I had to switch to a wind instrument. And that's where Brayer came in wonderfully. So I'm thankful to both of you for where I am today. I definitely wouldn't be here without the two of you. And I mean, there's so many wonderful memories from your time at Highland Park High School. You know, wonderful lifelong relationships that I've been able to forge because of the band. Trips to Florida, Michigan, the Grand Canyon.
I know.
I'll cover it up for now, but I can send it to you. Anyway, so this is not just a blast for the past for you. Yeah. So, of course, there are wonderful memories. You know, I can't speak for everybody from Highland Park High School, but I remember unloading boxes upon boxes upon boxes of oranges, wonderful band competitions, historic events. I distinctly remember that you turned on the TV in the band room so we could watch the verdict of the OJ trial. Mm-hmm. That was a lot of fun. Great memories of pep band, of marching band, of course. There we have another wonderful. I think some people that are in that picture are on the Zoom as well. In any case, these are all, you know, fond memories all tied together with a common thread being you. And while those are all great memories, what actually sticks with me the most is what we learned just in the day-to-day rehearsing and playing with you. Of course, you set high musical standards for us. You had infectious enthusiasm for music of all kinds. You imparted your endless musical wisdom to us, at least for a trombone player. But most of all, you taught us to want to be better players and better listeners and better people, and to do so for each other, so we could come together for this common goal of making music. And that in that sense of working together is what has stuck with me the most. And I think it stuck with everybody who went to Highland Park High School and had you as their band director there. Whatever field we went to, I think that's what sticks with me the most. And I think the greatest testament is to you is that after you left in my senior year, the phrase, but Mr. Williams used to do it this way, he used to do it that way, became regularity. We heard it every day, not just because we were familiar with the old ways, but because they reminded us of you and just what impact you had had on us. But of course, our loss was someone else's gain, as we're going to hear more about tonight. So I hope I can speak for all the HPHS band alums when I say that we're just so thankful for the time we had with you and that we wish you the very, very, very best on your well-deserved retirement. So by way of conclusion, let me say in the inimitable words of the Highland Park High School fight song emblazoned on this shirt.
I love that.
Whether up or whether down, you always smiled and never frowned unless we played out of tune, which was rare. But whether up or whether down, you always smiled and never frowned. We are proud of you, Mr. Williams. So let's raise a toast to Glenn. Thank you so much, and cheers, congratulations. Cheers.
So in the mid 90s, Glenn accepted a new teaching position at Forest Hills Central High School in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And it was during that tenure that he met Grace Shryock. Grace has served as the principal English horn in the Springfield Symphony Orchestra of Massachusetts, as oboist in the Albany Symphony Orchestra, and as an English horn soloist in the New York Philharmonic. Additionally, Grace has served as the principal English horn and assistant principal oboe with the Richmond Symphony. She's made appearances with the Baltimore and New Jersey Symphony Orchestras, Boston Lyric Opera, the Boston Modern Orchestra Project, as well as many other orchestras on the East Coast. She can be heard on recordings by the New York Philharmonic, the Boston Modern Orchestra Project, and Albany Symphony Orchestras, for which she served as principal oboe on a Grammy-nominated recording. Grace has served as an associate oboe teacher at the Manhattan School of Music and oboe instructor at the Virginia Commonwealth University, and she has conducted master classes at many prestigious schools of music all over the United States. After leaving Forest Hills Central High School and Glenn, Grace studied at the Manhattan School of Music and the Peabody Conservatory. Grace, thank you so much for being with us tonight. The Zoom is yours.
Thank you so much for having me here. I am going to have a hard time getting through this. Mr. Williams, hi! I miss you! It's so nice to talk to you. I didn't even get to my comments yet. Okay, here we go. All right, so I just want to tell you how much you've affected so many people so profoundly throughout your career. I am just one of thousands of students that you've worked with. And I know that every single one of us took something really important from our time with you. Speaking for myself personally, I became a musician because you made me believe that I could and that there was a future for me there. I'm not naturally a confident person, and I often second guess myself, and I have so many very vivid memories of you encouraging me and making me realize that this was something I was really good at and that there was something there And so I owe so much of what my life has become to you. And I'm very thankful for that. And your support didn't end when I graduated. Still to this day, you've shown me such constant support, and I can't even express to you in words how important that is to me. Outside of my parents, you are the one who shaped me as a person more than anyone else. You taught me how to enjoy life, how to work hard, and how to enjoy life while you're working hard. And speaking for everyone that you worked with, more than anything, I think you showed us how to be a good adult. You showed us how to treat kids and how to encourage them to be themselves and to grow into who they are. You showed us what it means to be there for someone and what it means to be reliable. Whether your students went into music or not, I know that we all took you with us when we grew up and became adults. And if I can become even half as good of an adult as you, then that will be really saying something. So if everyone could raise a glass. Mr. Williams, I want to thank you on behalf of everyone from FHC and want to congratulate you on an amazing career and on how many lives you have positively affected.
Hear, hear. Cheers. Grace, thank you so much. Thanks so much for being here tonight. Well, the final stop on the Glenn Williams Public School Tour has been Downers Grove South High School, where he serves as the chairperson for the Fine Arts Department. Emily Fernsler played clarinet in the DGS band program, and that's where she first met Glenn. As many of Glenn's former students will attest, just as Grace just did, his demonstrated passion for music has always been infectious. And when Emily left for the University of Notre Dame, there was no question that she was going to play in their wonderful marching band. But what Glenn might not know about Emily was that really she was just using him to get access to his son, Josiah. Of course, I'm totally kidding.
I'm good with that.
And as we already celebrated a little bit earlier tonight, Josiah and Emily are newlyweds, and those of us that know and love them couldn't be happier about that. So this next toast to represent Downers Grove South High School and the students of the DGS band is going to come from in the house, not on the Zoom. So Emily, come on over.
Hi, everyone. So as Breyer mentioned, before I was Emily Williams, I was Emily Fernsler, and I entered the Downers Grove South band as a freshman in 2009. And I was in Glenn's band. I was in the Wind Symphony. And, you know, and my mom was asking me, do you remember meeting Mr. Williams, Glenn? And I was like, no, you know, I don't. But my first memory of him was actually in rehearsal. And we're all getting ready to play, and he was very serious. Like that, when Glenn took the podium, it was like, all right, we're gonna learn something. And whether we wanted to or not, really. And we were ready, and we were ready to go. And it was this silly piece that maybe, I mean, you're all music nerds, so many of you probably know. It's called Yagi Bushi.
Oh.
And I'll never forget it because we ran it through one time and everyone was like, what are we doing with this? Like, this is not great. But there was like no giving up. Like Glenn was like, no, we're gonna learn this and we're gonna be good at it. And so every rehearsal he came in and like the word that comes to mind for me with Mr. Williams in a music setting is intentional. Like he comes in with a plan and he's intentional about it. And every rehearsal is like that. And by the end, like, I know that many of us, I'm emotional, I'm sorry, I don't know why. Like many of us have a memory of getting really good at that piece and it being silly, but us being really good at it. And that's my first memory. That's my first memory. So, and I know that so many of you, whether you're at Downers Grove South or not, like have so many rehearsal memories, probably very similar to that. With Mr. Williams, and that didn't stop after my freshman year. You know, I stayed in the band program. I was gung-ho about it, and every step of the way, he was there to support his students that cared about music, like I did, and kids that didn't. Like, he was invested in whatever you were invested in. Was it video games? was it you know, your art classes? Was it math? Like, whatever it was, he wanted to talk to you about it, which is cool. So I just want to thank you for being intentional in everything you do. Now with my father-in-law, you're incredibly intentional. but even as a band director for those 4 years, you care about your students, and the care that you poured into them reflects right back here. I think all of us are so grateful for how much you cared about us. So I want to thank you for that. Thank you for that. I also want to thank you for being such an intentional planner, not just in your rehearsals, but in your itineraries, in your agendas. This man, as we've all experienced probably a band trip or seven with him, he is incredibly good at the itinerary, and that's this man. If it's not this man, it's this man. And so these two are the absolute best planners, and that I have learned has translated to family vacations. And so I just want to thank you for that. And I think one of the biggest impacts on my life in that was the Germany trip, which if you were part of Niners Grow South, I know that Mr. Williams is a huge part in forging that relationship and keeping that relationship alive. And has been so impactful on our life, because there's so much to learn about the world and music when you see it outside of your bubble, outside of the United States. It's universal, and you brought that into my life. So I just want to raise a glass to Mr. Williams and to Glenn for being exactly who you are. You're intentional, and that means the world to everyone who knows you. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Emily. Well, because I've known Glenn for 30 years, I know how important Ray and Molly Kramer have been to him and to Terry. They think of the Kramers as family, and I know those feelings are reciprocated by Ray and Molly. For most of us gathered here tonight, the Kramers hardly need any introduction. But I do want to acknowledge what an honor it is to have with us the Indiana University Director of Bands Emeritus, Ray Kramer, and his wife, Molly Kramer, joining us from Colorado Springs. In May of 1988, as Glenn was graduating from IU, Mr. Kramer gave Glenn a baton with some advice inscribed on it. And it said, if I remember correctly, and I'm paraphrasing probably, but on it said, remember, this is only the equipment. The real music making comes from your heart. And that advice I know has guided Glenn for the past 33 years. So Mr. Kramer, we are so happy to have you. Mrs. Kramer, we are so pleased to have you here tonight. Please unmute yourself and we'd love to hear from you. Welcome.
Well, hi, Glenn and Terry. Good to see you. Congratulations on a fantastic career, and what a special honor it is to have this piece written for you, Glenn. And we were just delighted to be a part of this. And I just want you to know that I really like the name of the piece, Bare Bones. Because I remember so many times I would ask students, has anybody seen Glenn Williams? I've been looking for him all day today. And they said, last I saw him, he was over at Bears. Chomping at the pieces. Yep. I think you spent a lot of time there, Glenn. But we're just so delighted to be your Indiana University mom and dad, because that's what you were from the very first time we met you when you moved to Bloomington.
Terry and Glenn have been a part of our family, or Glenn especially, Terry along for the ride, I guess, while he was at IU, ever since he came to IU. And I kind of picked up where Gail and his mom left off, trying to raise him right. Did the best I could. He spent a lot of time on our family room floor, watching ball games, eating popcorn. He knew that my menus were up on the refrigerator. Once in a while, he'd stick his head in the door to see what we were going to have for dinner the next time around and make himself a guest. But I will tell you, he never complained about anything that I fixed. And we spent a really memorable week with them on their honeymoon. So any of you who have not taken friends along on a honeymoon, ask them all about that. We have never forgotten that time together. And Glenn, we love you and Terry and your family, and are so grateful for what you added to our family's life, because you were a big brother to Heather and to Jer, and the memories that you made with them and with us, or with us forever. And we thank you for giving us the opportunity to have you in our life.
So Glenn, I knew from the very beginning when you first came to IU that you were going to be a great success, because your musicianship, your personality, your passion, your desire to be the best that you can be was evident in everything that you did. I so much appreciate that we had the opportunity to be a part of your life during those very short years in Bloomington. And would you believe that it's taken all these years since 1987 to beat Michigan again? But anyway, I also want to say this to the people, to Brent, thank you for the piece. I was a little bit disappointed that I wasn't asked to be one of the solo trombonists with you, Glenn. And just because I haven't practiced for 55 years doesn't mean that I still can't play that third trombone part. I just want you to know that I got my horn out in the first week in March where this pandemic set in, and I've been practicing on a regular basis for the last 7 months. Talking about a high F, I've now gotten up to the F just above the staff. Anyway, so Molly and I would just like to toast you and thank you for everything that you've been in our lives and what you meant to us in Bloomington, and for what you've meant to thousands of students that have gone through your program over the years. You have impacted every single one of them, and we thank you, and we know you're going to continue to do that in the future. So congratulations and best wishes.
Cheers. You can play the second part down an octave.
How about two octaves?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Brent will add a fourth part.
Maybe it could be the outtakes on the video. You know?
Oh, thank you. I'm going to mute myself right now. I'm not going to respond to that.
Hey, so, Glenn, do you know what time it is in Europe right now?
Plus 6 hours.
It's tomorrow in Europe. This party has gone international. We're spanning, I think, 9 time zones tonight. This is huge. And we're actually partying in 2 different days at the same time, which I think is pretty cool. Glenn's musical influence and reach has frequently expanded past local community and has taken hundreds of students on music tours to Europe, both with the District 99 Honors Band and also the Blue Lake Fine Arts Camp International Program. And with both of those programs, Glenn has forged amazing partnerships and friendships with music teachers in France and Germany. In fact, I think 5 or 6 of them are on the call right now from France and Germany. So I want to especially say thank you to those people who are attending from the wee hours of Sunday morning. And I would like to ask if everyone could please give a nice warm welcome as I introduce to you Mr. Ryman Schiffer, who is the director of the Biedingheim-Biesingen Music School. Raymond, are you with us? Thank you for getting
yes.
The Zoom is yours.
Hello. Hello, Glenn. Hello, Terry. It's a special honor for me to be able to send my personal greetings from Biedingheim, Germany to Downers Grove to you, even it's early in the morning, 1:30 in the morning. It's a real gift that both of us had the chance to be a part of our outstanding cultural and musical exchange program that connects 2 nations, 2 cities, 3 schools, and 3 bands. Over the last 35 years, our program connected more than 2,000 students, teachers, and families of both sides of the ocean. It gave us the chance to share our music and to learn about each other. This seems to be nowadays more important than it was before. Thank you so much for your friendship and your partnership. I hope we will be able to stay in contact and to meet very soon again. Please raise your glasses. I'm Prosit from Germany to Glenn.
Prost! Prost, Ryman!
Prost!
Yeah!
I think Brielle knows the beer.
Only on my private trip to Germany.
Okay.
Yeah. Only on the private trip. Yeah. Ryman, thank you so much for being with us. And I know we have some other international guests here tonight too. And I'm just going to pause for a moment before we get to our last official toast and invite anyone who may not have done so already, feel free to type your greeting to Glenn in the chat, just to let him know that you are here tonight. And as we wrap up formally, we'll leave the Zoom going for a couple more minutes, especially for those international folks who have gotten up awfully early. I'd like them to be able to say hi to Glenn too, as the rest of us start to eat yummy food. So our final toast of the evening is going to be offered by someone who has become a great personal and professional friend of Glenn, especially in recent years, through their collaboration as administrators at Downers Grove South High School. Representing the hundreds upon hundreds of professional colleagues that Glenn has positively influenced and impacted over the past three decades, I'm very, very pleased to introduce an amazing educator in his own right. Please welcome Principal Ed Schwartz of Downers Grove High School. Ed, the Zoom is yours.
Thank you, Bear. As the non-music guy here, I heard bare bones and I was afraid that Glenn's orthopedic surgeon was singing a song about his knee joint or something, for crying out loud, bare bones. Clearly, I don't know the music very well, and I'm sure it'll be great. And the other thing I'm certain of is Glenn will use multi-syllable words to describe it. You know, there'll be a magical confluence of sonic sensations. So, but in all seriousness, Glenn and I began at South High together the same year. As they do to administrators, they made me come a few months early, and I was actually involved in hiring Glenn. So, and it was one of the best decisions the school has made. I get the opportunity, Glenn, often to represent our school. And you know how much I think of our school, and you know how much I think of the people in it. So it is my honor tonight to represent, as Brer said, the thousands of students like Emily and Josiah who you influence in the classroom and the hallways of South High School. It's my privilege to represent the hundreds upon hundreds of colleagues who've had the opportunity to work with you. But more importantly, it's my honor to represent those colleagues who now get to call you friend. So to you, my friend, congratulations on a great career. Thank you for the lives you've touched, including my own. Hear, hear.
Cheers. Cheers. All right. Hey, Glenn, before we bring this to formal conclusion, I'm just going to scroll the pages so you can see all these amazing faces and all these people who have tuned in tonight. Mm-hmm. Everybody can wave if you'd like to. They know they're being video recorded. I'll go back and forth a little bit. And Glenn, you do not have to speak, but we also want to just, if there's anything that you would like to say to this group before we sign off, we want to give you an opportunity if you want it. You don't have to take it.
Yeah. You each mean more to me than I can express in words. And the sentiments that have been shared tonight are mutually shared. What I learned from you is as significant in the relationship as anything else. Each of you enriched me, and the fact that we can still stay in touch through social media and all these things right now is the best part of teaching for me. So you should all know that I'm so incredibly proud of you, music or not music, just who you are as human beings and what you do to change the world is an incredible point of pride for me. So I raise a glass to each of you.
Aww. Woo-hoo. Aww. Awesome. We need to get you a refill is what we need. Well, I just, again, want to thank everybody for being here tonight and for your contributions to this commission. We will explain to Glenn later exactly how this came together through your very, very generous financial contributions to it. It's obviously we wanted to honor Brent for the time that he put into crafting such a wonderful piece of art, and also wanted to be able to produce what's going to be, I think, an incredible archival recording that's going to be produced remotely, but I think with a studio level of professionalism that's going to be really, really exciting. And Glenn, I want you to know that when we started this idea, when we kind of got together, Josiah and I contacted Brent about a year ago to start talking about this. And then we decided, okay, how are we going to scheme to kind of pull the money together? The money that we needed actually quickly outpaced, or the donations quickly outpaced what we actually needed. And we raised over $700,000 for this project, which we're going to give you the opportunity to select a charity that you'd like to donate the remaining money to. So to everyone who was a part of this, just thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. And I don't want to like hit end meeting because that just feels weird, but I am going to, so this isn't totally socially awkward and weird. The rest of us here are going to start to get some hors d'oeuvres and nibble, and I'm going to leave this open for a couple minutes. If you'd like to say hi to Glenn and unmute yourself for a second, and we'll just start mingling. That sounds okay.
Perfect.
Sound okay? All right. So take care, everybody, if you're on your way out. And thanks so much.
Bye bye. Cheers.
Cheers. Good night, Raymond.
Bye bye.
Good night, Rick and Katrine.
Oh, hello.
Bye, Jer.
Good night,
Terry. Good night. Bye, Williamses.
Bye.
Night, guys.
Bye.
Congratulations.
Well, I see your winterizing of your front lawn went so.
Yeah.
Yes. I Mike all day, I was like, he does not know. So great date night, right?
Yeah.
And we still went to the same brewery I said we were gonna go to. So happy evening. Congratulations. Good night.
Hey Jessica.
Hi. Can you wave?
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Glenn and Terry.
Hey.
Congratulations to both of you.
I'm excited.
Hey, Regina. Hey, Andres. Hey, Aaron.
Bye, Mr. Williams. Thank you for everything.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. Good to see you. Enjoy your evening.
Thank you.
I can't believe you guys got up.
Bye-bye. Congratulations again.
Thank you. Nice shirt, Peter. I love it. They were committed.
Rare. Thank you very much for everything you did.
Hey, Bob. Great to see you.
Brother.
See you, Uncle Bob.
It is overwhelming to see the impact you've had on so many lives. I think that you are an example to many, many people and a great example. Congratulations.
Thanks. Love you.
Love you too, man.
My love to you, Mr. Williams.
Back to you. Thank you so much.
I can't wait till I can see you in real life again someday. That'll be great. And I'm sorry I cried before I even started talking.
I think I beat you to it.
When your image came on the screen, and you just went.
Have fun tonight.
Hey, thanks.
Okay, I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hey, Rick and Katrine.
Hey.
Hello, America.
How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Tired.
Thank you for that.
It's earlier here than in Germany. Oh. We come over soon, eh? Bye-bye.
You can come back also. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We didn't prepare anything, but we are agree with all things other people say to you. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Terry was asking,
cheers.
Is your family good? Okay.
Cheers.
Hey, Miles.
Hello.
Hey, thanks for the heads up on the microphone issue.
Oh yeah, no worries. It's I don't know who brought it up first, but I think it was just some interference and then whatever happened with the microphone. But you know, it obviously, congratulations, Glenn. It's, you've obviously had a super illustrious career. It kills me that I'm not able to be there in person celebrating with you all tonight. Because you know, you've had such a tremendous impact on me as a person. And I will always remember, I haven't had too many opportunities to work with you directly as a teacher, but I will always remember the opportunity to work with you in the District 1 Middle School Jazz Ensemble. And playing under you in that ensemble is one of the best musical experiences I've ever had. And it's something that I will always remember and cherish because, you know, someone who I've looked up to for so long is just as a person. I got to see, you know, what you do every day and the kind of impact that you have on students. And I will always remember that not only were you super driven and you pushed us to sound our best, the sense of community, even in that just one day that, you know, you brought us all together and it was a really cohesive group because you encouraged us to get to know each other and, you know, hang out during the breaks. And just, I had so much fun playing that day because, you know, of your leadership. And it, you know, that's, it's a musical memory that I'll always, I will always cherish. And so thank you for that. And again, it you know, it kills me a little bit that I can't be at my own home to celebrate with you all tonight, but congratulations on a great career. And I know that, you know, in a few weeks when I come back to the Chicago area, I will be able to see you again in person.
Can't wait.
And congratulations to the Hoosiers as well, unfortunately.
You were the first person I texted today.
Thank you.
Oh. Love you, Miles.
Bye. Love you too.
Good night, Rick. Good night, Katrine.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Good night.